Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about the range function, which will be used in some later videos. I will also briefly talk about the scientific format of numbers. The range function is a commonly used function in Python. It can take three parameters: start, stop, and step. Only the stop parameter is mandatory. The other two are optional. All the parameters must be integer numbers. The function returns an immutable sequence of integer numbers from start to stop, including start but not including stop, with an interval of step. Let's see some examples. Range 10 will generate a sequence of integer numbers from 0 to 10, including 0 but not including 10, with a step of 1. To see this more clearly, we can show this range as a list using the list function like this. The list consists of 10 integer numbers from 0 to 9 enclosed with a pair of brackets. This statement generates a sequence of numbers from 5 to 10, including 5 but not including 10, with a step of 1. This one generates a sequence of numbers from 5 to 10, including 5, but not including 10, with a step of 2. We see 5, 7, and 9. In this statement, the start is 5, the stop is 1, and the step is negative 1. We will generate a sequence of numbers from 5 to 1, including 5, but not including 1, with a step of negative 1. The result is 5, 4, 3, and 2. The range function is mostly used in the for loop for repeatedly execute some statements multiple times. In this program, we import the math library first because we will use the factorial function as a library. In the first statement, we will generate a sequence from 0 to 31, including 0 but not including 31, with a step of 5. I is the loop index. It will be assigned each value in this range. For each I, the loop body prints out the index I itself and the factorial of I. By definition, 0 factorial is equal to 1. 5 factorial is 120. 10 factorial is 3628800, and so on. 30 factorial is a very large integer number. From the above example, we see that Python integers don't have a fixed size in the computer memory, and they automatically expand to represent large values. However, the memory may overflow if the number is too large. Float numbers, on the other hand, have a fixed size. They are approximate numbers. They allow us to represent a large range of values, but with lower precision. Very large and very small float numbers are expressed in scientific or exponential notation. For example, this is a very large float number because it has a decimal point. When we run this cell, the output is 1.3e plus 20. It means 1.3 times 10 to the power of positive 20. This expression means negative 1.3 times 10 to the power of positive 5. Or negative 130,000. This very small number will be represented by 1.3 times 10 to the power of negative 7. And this one means negative 1.3 times 10 to the power of negative 2. It doesn't matter whether we use lowercase e or uppercase e. They are the same. Now let's check this program. The only difference between this one and the previous one is that we convert the integer factorial value to a float number. Read the output. Now we don't get the accurate results anymore for a large number like 30 factorial. This is because the float numbers are approximations. Okay, I just talked about the range function and the scientific notation in this video. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.